It is your girl Akira Faith, and welcome back to my channel. If you have not yet, make sure you subscribe and join the community, y'all. Look, y'all, I am currently out of town and I am still in the process of moving, so that's why I have not made any content for these past couple days. But I was like, look, school is next week for me, and I know it's a lot of y'all nursing students that want like some honest tips and reviews on like what you're gonna look forward to in nursing school. So I was like, you know what, let me stop being a perfectionist, because I always feel like I have to have a great setting and everything has to be perfect for me to record. But no, like, I need to get this video out to y'all ASAP. If you want all of my honest nursing school tips for incoming nursing students, keep watching till the end. Make sure you subscribe to Butterfly Gang and join the community, y'all. Yeah, let's hop right into this video. So the first question you want to ask yourself is, why do you want to become a nurse? I wish someone asked me this question, because look, if you want to become a nurse for stability and like money and like just the wrong reasons, nursing school is really going to break you, honestly. Nursing school is not peaches and cream, butterflies everywhere. It's really not like that. And you really are giving your all. You really have to care for people and be compassionate, be passionate in your job a little bit. It takes a lot of discipline, and it's just a lot that goes into nursing school and just nursing in general. As I'm working in a hospital, it's a lot on you mentally, physically, and just so much. So just ask yourself, why do you want to become a nurse? If you cannot list at least 5 reasons of why you want to become a nurse, then I would not suggest that you do this, because I promise you guys, it is not rainbows in the healthcare field. It is really not. And no, you don't have to just work in the hospital, and there are like a lot of different things you can do in nursing. It's good to get in it. It's very flexible and everything, but you have to have the heart for it. Okay, y'all, so I had to put it in a different angle because the sun just went down. But yes, I wish someone told me that nursing school is money. For my pre-nursing students and my nursing students that's going into the program, you need to have money. Those nursing books can range from like 1K to 2K. I'm just gonna put that out there. It depends on the program, it depends on the school. So make sure you have money saved up for nursing school, because a lot of things cost so much. Some nursing schools have different programs that you use, like Evolve and stuff like that. So you're gonna need like money on the side saved up. Make sure you work as much as you could before you get nursing school, or while in nursing school. Like, try your best to have money saved. And that is my number one tip. My second tip is, read your books, okay? Read your books. I do not care if people can get by in school without reading. No, books that you read has all the material you need, okay? I know some people gonna be like, well, I didn't have to read. Some people are like me. I gotta read material over and over and over to get things. I'm just different like that. I don't have everybody else's mind that I can just read it once and that's it, or I don't have to read it. Like, no, read your books, y'all. You're gonna be a nurse and you have somebody's life in your hands. Don't let it be because you didn't read the book and you don't have the knowledge of what to do that you actually kill somebody. Yes, I'm gonna make it that serious, because it is that serious. And also, if you don't read, you might fail, okay? No, from experience. So read your books, y'all. You're gonna see that your courses that you take, it's gonna build off of each other. So it's important you read, because what you see in one thing, you're gonna also see in another. It's all interconnected. Another tip is to find a study method early. Make sure you find a study method that's best for you. I can sit here and tell you the ways that I study, but it may not help you. Only you know like your study methods. Some people use flashcards. Some people just study straight out the book. When I took like my core classes, like history and stuff like that, I found ways to study, and I kind of use those same ways in nursing school as well. And so just developing a study method help me, you know, figure out how I study best. But I'm also a visual learner, so videos, pictures, and stuff like that, YouTube, that helped me to study a lot. Another tip I have is, you need to form and find study groups. I can't study with people because I get distracted easily, but it is also helpful to study with people, because it's like you learn something they learned, also like they learn something you learned, you know? You kind of like bounce ideas off of each other. You guys really can like help each other out, and y'all can pass together. Two is better than one, I'ma just say that. Like, it's a lot on you when you just study by yourself. I'm a loner. I'm kind of like an introvert. I can be an extrovert, but I'm like mostly an introvert. I like to be to myself, but like I like to have fun and stuff. So if I'm talking to somebody and I like really vibe with people, I tend to get distracted and I tend not to focus a lot. That's why I don't form the study groups. But this semester, this second one, I'm changing that up. I'm forming me some study groups, and you just have to have the discipline to get your work done. That's all. So form the study groups, y'all. It will really help. Another tip I have is organization. You guys have to be organized, and not just physically, like with books and stuff, mentally, spiritually. Like, you gotta be organized in nursing school, because nursing school is probably gonna drive you insane. I'm just gonna put that out there. And if you're not organized, that just adds on to the level of stress that you're gonna have. Based on my experience, some days I was organized, for weeks I was unorganized. It just piled on a lot more stress. Then I started procrastinating. Like, it's just a lot when you're not organized. Like, you just feel like everything around you is chaotic. You stay organized. If something is undone, put it back. If you feel all over the place mentally, you need to bring yourself back. Talk to the Most High, whoever you believe in, and like get yourself back together, because you're gonna need the Lord in nursing school. It's a lot mentally, physically as well. When you go to clinicals, it's a lot on your body physically. You need to stay organized in your body. Make sure you have a routine and stuff. So you need to know that self-care is very important in nursing school, because if you don't take care of yourself during this time, things are not going to go well for you. A lot of people gain weight in nursing school. A lot of people don't take care of themselves in nursing school. I would suggest you create like a morning and night routine for yourself. You need to take care of your mental, spiritual, physical health. So the purpose of the self-care and creating these routines are to take care of all three of those things, because you're going to need that. There are times that I literally ate food, went to school, did what I have to do, and then went to bed. Did not take care of myself, did not worry about how I looked, and just things like that. And honestly, I felt bad. I didn't feel good. Was always tired, gained weight here and there. I wish somebody told me that Akira, you need a routine. Go ahead and build you one. I'm gonna throw out the things that could help you in nursing school. It's gonna be a lot. You need to plan ahead. I like to read at least a week ahead my material. So read your chapters before you go to class. So when your teacher talks about it, you can highlight what's important. Plan ahead. Make sure you have all your important dates on what needs to be done. Don't do things last minute. Like, just plan ahead, y'all. You need to have time management, discipline, and you need to have a mindset change. All that is already said and done. You kind of already know what that means. Ask questions. Look, if you do not understand what A, B, C, and D is, you need to say something. Ask your professor. They are there to help you. They get paid to help you. They are professors for a reason. Ask those questions. I don't care if people think you are sickening. I don't care if people look at you funny. Ask those questions, because if you do not know, you're never gonna know. Make sure you move your body and exercise, because most of the time you're sitting down and you're reading. Make sure you exercise so you prevent weight gain and just being very unhealthy. Exercising is a great stress reliever. I also exercise to relieve stress, because that's how I run it off and get that energy. It's good for like motivation, and it's good to just boost your energy. It's important you pay attention to details, because I kind of miss like little things when I first started nursing school. Like, with the tourniquet, I'm so used to going to a hospital and they put on the tourniquet like once to do like phlebotomy. They can just stick you and they get it. But I didn't know like you apply the tourniquet twice to do an IV. My second time retaking skills, I finally like figured it out. Like, oh my God, you put on a tourniquet twice. I did not know that. I don't know how I missed that. I don't know how I missed that in my skills checkoffs, because I did it in the skills checkoff. But it was based off memorization. It's like I understood the purpose. Pay attention to details. Don't just try to do it based off memorization, because you can miss things. No matter how small or how big, pay attention to every detail in nursing school. Grades aren't rounded in nursing school. If you get a 70, you failed. Get a 71, you failed. If you get a 72, 73, 74, you failed. Get a 75 on up, you passed. Whatever you get is what you get.
I wish somebody told me that.
Make sure you guys create goals. I did not do this, and now I will do it this second semester. It will help you hold yourself accountable. It can help you pinpoint, well, why didn't you do 2, 3, and 4? Why didn't you, you know, complete this goal? And you can go back on your mess and be like, oh, because I procrastinated. I need to get that under control. I was on social media all day. Oh, because I was binge watching on Netflix. That's why. It just helps you hold yourself accountable and help me achieve stuff, you know, and make myself feel better, you know, motivate me, pat myself on the back. I don't know if people tell y'all this, but get some sleep. If you have to study till 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, fine, do it. You need sleep to function, y'all. Your brain can't think when you don't sleep. You get anxiety, you procrastinate. You need to sleep, y'all. Sleep is important. I actually go to bed at like 9 or 10. I want to go to bed around like 7 or 8, but that's probably not going to happen. The latest I like to go to bed is like 9:30. I cannot watch anything. I cannot do anything. 9:30 is sleep. Ooh, I wish somebody told me that not everyone has experience. Always be thinking I'm the dumbest person in class. I know I shouldn't say that, but like I'd be really beating myself up because I'd be like, bro, I feel like I should know this. Why don't I know that? No. Not everybody has experience. Not everybody works in the hospital. Don't feel like you're the only one. Don't feel like just because they have more experience, like working as an LPN or things like that, that they know everything. No, they don't. They learning just like you. They in school just like you. Everybody has to help each other out and bounce ideas off of each other. So don't think that you are, oh, I'm so stupid, I should know this. No, you are smart, you are learning, you all are learning, you all are in the same boat. I feel like nursing school can be very competitive, but no, like, everybody need to work together. I wrote down, don't compare what's done in the hospital to what's done in school. Hospital may have different policies or not everyone follows the same rules. So like I was saying, like some LPNs in their hospitals, they might've learned something differently than what is being done in school. Because school and hospital, you mostly learn like the same stuff, but at the same time, the hospital policy is different from the school. So just because the hospital does this does not mean the school does this. So make sure you always listen to your school first, if that makes sense. And learn how to like separate the two in nursing school. Learn how to separate what you learn in the hospital and what you learn in school. It will meet in the middle, trust me. It's not gonna be too different. It's not going to be all off. You're not going to be too confused, but you need to remember like what is in nursing school. That's what the teachers want to know about. They don't want to know about what you know, learn only in a hospital. You're learning from nursing school right now. One of my biggest challenges in nursing school, and I wish somebody helped me and told me about that, is procrastination. I'm a very heavy procrastinator. And when I finally do it at the last minute, like a day before, I get it done. And I stress myself out so much. And I just be like, wow, I could have read that. I could have actually done that had I read that book. I could have actually done that had I just got on it and paced myself and timed myself and just made myself do it. My mind, my mental makes things bigger and harder than what it is. So if you're like me, if you're a procrastinator, please, you cannot procrastinate in nursing school. It will really affect you. Look, you can do it. Don't create this mental box in your mind. You can write that paper in a week. You can read that book in a week. You can do it. I've been in college for close to 3 years now. I wish somebody told me I might experience nursing student burnout. Y'all, this last semester, I was starting to get so burnt out because I've taken like, I don't know how many classes. I got like over 100 credits. I am tired of being in school. School can be very challenging. Sometimes you just don't feel like reading. Because I've been reading for a while now. Sometimes you just don't feel like writing a paper. Sometimes you just don't feel like it. You may experience burnout and nobody talks about it. You may experience burnout when you start doing clinicals. Nobody talks about that. Things that I've listed or the things that I have talked about, you have to put those things in action. That's why you should do the self-care and take care of your body. That's why you should do the routines and like keep your mind organized and keep yourself in order and keep yourself in check. That's why you should do those things. All these things are to help you. Nobody talks about burnout, but it is real. We got two more left, y'all. Start figuring out your scope of practice. Now, you're gonna get your experience eventually as you do clinicals and go to the hospitals and stuff, but no, you need to plan out and figure out what you wanna do in healthcare. I always said I wanted to work in a NICU. Like, that's something I said when I was going in. And as I'm learning different things in clinicals and stuff, still wanna work in NICU, but I haven't reached that yet. But still, I see more different things that I would probably do too. Make sure you list the things you want to do. Like, have an idea so you won't get to the end and feel like, oh, I don't know what to do. Like, list out, I want to work in a NICU. I might want to do labor and delivery. I might want to do med surg. Make sure you have an idea so you won't get, like, pressured in your last semester when you do your preceptorship. I got one last question for y'all. Are you willing to do what it takes to become a nurse? It's not easy. Becoming a nurse, as I'm getting the experience, even though I'm a nursing student, but I actually work with nurses now, and y'all, I was completely fooled. I looked on like how Pinterest made it look, how social media made it look. No, I was completely fooled. But I do care for people. I do like healing people. I do like helping people. I wasn't completely fooled, but at the same time, I'm thinking it's sunshine. It's not. It's not always sunshine. There are good days, there are bad days, there are in-between days. But you really have to ask yourself, am I going to do what it takes to become a nurse? Are you going to study those long hours? Are you going to sacrifice those parties? Are you going to sacrifice those job days where you have to go to school? Are you going to sacrifice? It's a serious question. It really is. And I'm not trying to scare y'all, but I'm here to be honest based off my experience. Are you willing to do what it takes to become a nurse? And if you say, you know what, Kira? Yes, I'm willing. I know it's going to be hard, but I'm willing. And I got God by my side. You good. You a nurse. You a nurse. You already a nurse. It's done. If you say, oh, no, I ain't doing that, go ahead and hang this career up. Go ahead and hang it up. Go ahead and find you another one. You got to do what it takes. But if you can do it, you can do it. You can do it. If you can't and if you're not willing, it's not going to work out in your favor. I'm going to just tell you that right now. So, think on these things, y'all. These are the tips. Y'all see how dark it got? I recorded this video for a while. I hope these tips were helpful. I hope you wrote down some notes. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and turn on post notifications for when I post. And I will see y'all in my next video. Bye, butterfly gang.